South Park. I fucking feel old all of a sudden. I
know. Is it 25 years since they started it, or is it 25 seasons? I'm not sure. I remember when South Park just was starting, I was at a party, a big Hollywood party. It was a Comedy Central party. Doug talks about it in one of his books, Robert Evans's house.
Yeah.
We jump into the pool. We're raising hell. But that was the first season of South Park, because they were, those guys were there. Didn't meet him. I ended up getting chased around by Gary Busey, was kind of my celebrity thing there. I cut in a dinner line or a buffet line with, you know, like you did. I wouldn't normally do this, but there was some of the ladies from the show that we called them juggies, but a few of the juggies were there. This big line, Robert Evans did this big spiel about nobody really knew. He was, it's like a madman talking, you know, blah, 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 and Hollywood, and, hey, Slash is here. It's just a aimless speech. And then we all got in this line, and a couple of the juggies waved me in line. They go, oh, join us. I'm okay. So I get in line, and then the next thing I know, Gary Busey, who I don't know which direction, I found out later, he was in front of me. So Gary Busey's in front of me in line, sees me joining the line behind him, and takes it as a personal insult. Like he seemed angry. And he was like right there. He's like a bigger dude, and he's in my face saying, you cut in line. And he goes, you gotta move back. And I was like, oh, this is fucking, it's that guy, Gary Busey, that's, you know, legendary big fucking teeth, you know,
like a horse.
Yeah, like, you know, I got the Lethal Weapon version, not the Buddy Holly. So I got, you know, he's fucking intense, and he says, I got to move back. So I move back a couple, so I'm moving back incrementally, but that's not good enough. So Gary wants me to move all the way to the very end of the line, which was about, 60 people are watching me get, harassed by Gary Busey. Right. I mean, the whole time I just kept moving back, and he was right there. Like, that's no farther, until I got to the very end of the line. I was the last person in line, and he goes, now doesn't that feel better? And wow. I go, yeah, I guess it does, Gary. And then that was the end. That was the end of our conversation. I didn't see him again the rest of the party. Some lady tried to, I was waiting to go hear Obama. This was a few years ago, obviously. And some lady, you know, sat her lawn chair behind me, and there was a lot of other. So it's like she did the same thing. And I'm remembering what Gary Busey taught me, and I gave her the same thing. I go, somebody at the end of this line isn't going to get in here because you think you can sit your chair here. And I moved. I didn't have the Gary Busey walked. I could have walked her 500 people back, but I just shamed her into leaving my area.
I think this is the first time in my life I've ever felt like cell phones were invented too late, because I would love to see that on video, this old Gary Busey and doing a good job of intimidating you.
He's intimidating. I don't know how tall he is, but he's definitely bigger than the average actor.
Plus, he's fucking psychotic.
He's mental too. And there was no like, oh, well, thanks, Gary. Nice to meet you.
Can I get your autograph?
Yeah. But I saw him one time. This was many years later. There was some actress doing an interview, and Gary Busey jumps right into the fucking interview, and it wasn't about him at all.
Wow. Like,
dude, you don't even follow your own advice, you know?
Yeah.
You get to the back of the line, but it's okay for you to jump into somebody's interview. Fucking loose cannon idiot.
He's fucking crazy, man. That's definitely one for the books. You've got to have somebody illustrate that, like do a little cartoon of it. So
he was jabbering the whole time, like line cutting, under his breath. I couldn't quite make it out, but I don't think he fancies line cutting.
Well, yeah, or he was just looking for somebody, and you happened to be his victim of that day. That's the, crazy that he is.
That was a fun party, but Gary,
Robert Evans, the kid stays in the picture. Now, I got a question. Is he this guy on Twitter that says the one and only Robert Evans? Is he still
alive?
I doubt
it. I don't know that he's even alive, but
I didn't think so either.
Yeah, he was like me and Doug were, we weren't, well, we had a PR person who was watching out for Doug, and we were getting drunk, and then we wanted to get into the inner sanctum, because there, you know, there's always a better place at the party. So we were like, where's, you know, so we get finally get into Robert Evans' inner sanctum. So me and Doug, and we're drunk. We've, you know, we've already been in the pool. You know, Doug was naked. I went down to my shorts because I didn't know. It was my first Hollywood party. So we finally get into the back room. Robert Evans is doing like a meet. You know, oh, hello. And he goes, he says to Doug, he goes, oh, hey, it's going to be great working with you on Comedy Central. Because like Robert had a cartoon show with Slash for a minute.
I didn't know
it was,
that.
Yeah, it was real. It was one season, a half a season. But that's why this party was at Robert Evans. And he was like, oh, it's great to meet you. It's going to be a fine season on Comedy Central. And Doug goes, cut the shit, Bob. Where's the blow? And and then he just went. He went real paranoid. He started. He had some. He goes, I can't even leave the place here. They'll plant cocaine on me. They said they put it in my, like, you know, something like real paranoid like that. And then Robert Shapiro whips around and kind of interrupts, you know, misdirects and gets Robert out of the conversation. And then I'm all red faced drunk. And I did take this picture, and I don't know if I still have it, but I did took a picture of me and Shapiro, and I'm all red faced, but I started, you know, in on the OJ shit. And so already the two main dudes in the party don't want us to, you know, we're in their room now, and they're like, what the fuck? And then Craig Kilborn was in the hot tub with a bunch of ladies. And so I think mainly we were looking for cocaine. So I started going, hey, Kilborn, where's the coke? And, and he's got like four or five ladies in this tub. And, I go, come on, those ladies ain't sitting with you because you're funny. And then one of the ladies gets up and starts jabbing at us, like, you know, obviously cocaine jaw, like, blah, 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 this is very rude of what you read. And then, then we get kind of kicked out of the room, and we're, and I had swiped something from the room. It was like a little, I think it was, it, what it looked like was a pet urn, like a small, like maybe a cat's urn or something, but it was just something like that. And I pocketed that, and then we were outside of the party, outside of the main room, and there's Slash. So, and then Slash is, we're talking to Slash, having a good time, and he's inviting us to go to the Viper room. And then I don't know, I was fumbling that thing, and he goes, hey, man, you didn't steal that from Robert, did you? So, like, Slash is accusing me, and then Doug covered for me. He goes, no, he carries that thing with him everywhere. And whatever it was, we gave it to our limo driver that night.